Hey, how's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to show you guys three of the best VPNs you could use for Chromecast. So if you didn't know, Chromecast will allow you to stream services, of course, on non-smart TVs, but unfortunately, you won't be able to, let's say, download a VPN onto the Chromecast itself. So unless you have a smart TV with a Google store and everything, you'll be able to download, let's say, ExpressVPN, NordVPN, or Surfshark on your smart TV, but not on your Chromecast. So what you can do, of course, is one of two things. So first of all, you could use a hotspot. And with a hotspot, let's say if you have your VPN, let's say you have one of these VPNs, you have a subscription, and if you're on PC, if you're on a mobile device, let's say you have your VPN on your Android, you can turn on your hotspot, connect to the VPN, and then use that hotspot to connect to your or connect your Chromecast to that hotspot. And that's how you can get that connection. Let's say you're trying to unblock an American library, a Netflix library. That's how it's going to work. Now, as a disclaimer, a VPN service should never be used to bypass copyright regulations. I don't promote, condone, or endorse the use of the service for such purposes. But if you're interested in any of these VPNs mentioned today, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full-on reviews if you'd like to know the ins and outs of these VPNs in terms of privacy policy, speed, streaming, and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. So, you know, all of these VPNs are actually very viable. So be it NordVPN, ExpressVPN, or Surfshark, they all have guides, quite a bit comprehensive, really. Here, they'll tell you exactly what to do. So if you're on NordVPN or ExpressVPN, they have all these guides you can use on the, you can check out on the website. So, you know, you could, as I said, you could use a Wi-Fi hotspot. You could install it on your router if you have a compatible router, or you could use a virtual VPN router, which you could also set up on your Windows or Mac, which is also listed in the guide right here. So if you're interested, of course, you can check the websites themselves and you can set it up for Chromecast. Now, or you could do the easy way, which is use a hotspot, which is, I think it's a pretty smart way of kind of not having to get a specific router that's compatible with your VPN, let's say, or having to set up a virtual router. Now, for reference, let's say you're trying to unblock Netflix. I just want to kind of give you guys a little brief about these VPNs. So first of all, if you're using these VPNs, definitely would recommend using the lightweight UDP protocol with ExpressVPN, and definitely stick with the NordLynx protocol with the NordVPN, and then the WireGuard protocol with Surfshark VPN, which is, these three are the best performing protocols in each of these VPNs. So definitely stick with those, especially if you're streaming and want the fastest connection. Now, in terms of servers, we have up to more than 3,000 servers in 94 countries. With ExpressVPN, NordVPN has over 5,300 servers in 59 countries, and then Surfshark will be in the middle with over 3,200 servers in 65 countries. So, of course, ExpressVPN, by virtue of having more regions, will be able to unblock more services. So, you know, for reference, Netflix is able to unblock over 18 Netflix libraries. And that'll be 10 with Nord and 15 with Surfshark. So again, Surfshark really being kind of a happy medium here in between ExpressVPN and Nord. And of course, it being such a budget VPN here, kind of getting the job done at the least possible cost. So yeah, the pricing is very generous here with Surfshark without really sacrificing or let's say, yes, just sacrificing any features. You're still getting plenty of features: static IP, multi-hop, split tunneling, which is called whitelister here, ad blocker, and a handful of protocols, as well as a kill switch. Of course, all these VPNs have a kill switch and split tunneling. So yeah, plenty of features, but within the context of unblocking streaming services, From my experience, I have tested ExpressVPN with over 100 services, with over 100 streaming services, all kinds of services, you know, from some of the most obscure ones all the way to the most popular ones like Disney Plus, HBO, Hulu, all kinds of streaming services. It only did not work with two. So very high consistency rate, over 95%. So if that's what you're looking for, as well as like the top security, definitely go with ExpressVPN. And if you're looking for something a little cheaper, let's say, because ExpressVPN is a little bit on the expensive side, typically compared to other VPNs. And it also allows you to secure up to 5 devices per subscription. Nord will allow up to 6 devices per subscription, and Surfshark will allow an unlimited amount. So that's also another very great selling point with Surfshark right here. So great stuff. So yeah, overall, that's pretty much it. Again, if you're interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full-on reviews. So I would definitely recommend checking out the reviews before making a purchase. And if you do decide to go back on your purchase, let's say you get Nord, Surfshark, and decide to go with ExpressVPN later on, you do have 30 days to change your mind with their 30-day money-back guarantee on all of these VPNs across all of their plans. So it's super convenient. Just contact their live chat support, which is available 24/7, and they'll process the refund very easily. So that'll be it for this video. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a wonderful day.